They really moved the logos to Michiru's butt in Kato's lap.
Ensemble Stars, music!
Hey besties, I already know that this video is gonna be a big chungus, so feel free to grab some snacks, grab some drinks, and get comfy. Because I'm gonna talk about my experience with Enstars music after about a year and like 2 months, and then I'm gonna give you a tour of my account as it is right now. So first of all, technically I'm not completely new to Enstars since I tried playing Basic during Butterfly Izumi way back in December 2018. I played through the tutorial, rolled for Izumi, and quickly uninstalled after not getting him. I was deceived into thinking Izumi was a chill character purely based off of the card's immaculate vibes. So yeah, I haven't had the time yet to go back and read all of the Basic stories, so even though music gives me a general idea of past lore, whenever one of the characters referenced something specific from Basic that hasn't been fully covered in music, I feel like they're performing Inception on me. Imposter syndrome, except I'm actually an imposter. Actually, the first Enstar story I ever read was a fan translation of Obligato before the English version was released. I saw the cards and I thought, hee hee hoo hoo, religious motif. So, yeah. Without spoiling anything, I'm just gonna say I was not prepared for how absolutely dire the lore can get. Like, I thought Hypmic lore was wild, but I'd say Enstars lore goes absolutely bonkers. Me at the Enstars cast.
You're a victim!
Here we go, CSI.
Anyway, I decided to play Enstars music because reason number one, it's a rhythm game, so it was much easier for me to get into compared to Enstars Basic. And reason number two, there's an English version, of course, which I pre-registered to because reason number three, I'm still coping with double A-sides end of service. And since my best boy from Argonavis is Kenta, I decided to produce Aiden, specifically Ibata, thanks to the absolute chokehold Hashimoto Shinichi has on me. Anyway, back to my experience with the game itself. I'm just gonna go over highlights in chronological order. The last day of the Linkly collab, August 26th, 2022, was the day of my despair, where I was just one day short of fully uncapping the Makoto. I don't remember if I could have used Daya to get more puzzle pieces, but either way, I will always be salty about this level 75 Makoto because there's no way in hell they're ever gonna bring him back. And I would have finished it on time if in-game instructions weren't hilariously unclear sometimes. Me, anytime Enstars doesn't give me extremely direct, step-by-step, crystal-clear instructions on how to do campaigns. Not finishing the Sanrio collab though was a skill issue on my part. Apparently, Enstars wanted us to work like dogs for Hello Kitty because I just played casually and I didn't even come close to getting the limited title. No, I did not encounter with Sanrio characters. And as you can see, I didn't even try to decorate my stage. At least I fully uncapped this hella pixelated Midori. Never again will I miss out on fully uncapping limited campaign cards. During Christmas, I was a fiend at putting Xmas balls on golden trees. Xmas balls is crazy though, cause Natsume even mentioned ornaments in his voice line. And that's a whole lot of balls.
Christmas tree ni osakana o kazaritai tte ittara minna ni dai hantai sarechaimashita.
Christmas wa nanika yotei aru no kashira? Nakattara de ii nakedo, atashi to issho ni dinner demo ikanai?
Lunar New Year was goated. I got ass, star, rats, and 2-star ass. Me when I do the audition scout. I got 5 copies of Bogey Time Ibarra, aka the best card in the game.
Sign me the fuck up! Good shit! Good shit! That's some good shit! Right there, right there! If I do say so myself,
During Valentine's, I was a chocolate-making fiend, gathering all those ingredients. And the Valentine's handshake was cute. Nagisa Riz, Hajime lying, cute June, playful Hiyori, honest Ibarra, wholesome. Who remembers Arashi's birthday banner before it got fixed, where it was red and in Korean? We international, baby. White Day was not as fun as Valentine's Day because you had to meet everyone on block scheduling just so they could give you bouquets. Not to be dramatic, but Makoto's White Day voice line changed the trajectory of my life forever. I even unlocked his practice outfit and got the break room background just so I could relive the moment. I was neutral about him before this, especially after August 26th, 2022. But now, Makoto-P's, I understand. I owe you an apology. I wasn't really familiar with your game. And I know some of you may be thinking, he's just doing the bashful emote. Everyone has one. And while that is true, and Mika and Shinobu in particular are also adorable, I award Makoto with one of the highest honors known to man, the scrunkly. As in, aww, the scrunkly. Double tap now if you'd scrunkly the when. At one point, we couldn't change our name, or our bio, or even message anyone. So for a while, I was stuck as Ibarra Slaygusa, complaining about Fight for Judge ensemble time. Also, I maxed out my talent in March, so it took me about 9 months. Shout out to work boost and accuracy specifically. April Fool's was a whole ass production. This is the power of the Ensemble Stars budget. The stories were goofy too, just the way I like them.
Hello, Koga. I am Uruf.
Kureai 11 Park.
Please! 僕たち天照院 H がいれば、暗乱分子の粛清などたやすい。
Bukuburu stars. Is Ray okay? Probably not, huh? human mode was fine, but wolf? This is like Project Sekai on Master. This is like Rebirthday on Bandori. This is like D4DJ on Expert. Twink became Wonk. I don't know what to tell you.
Are we human?
Also, April Fools happened to be on the first day of Tales of Antiques, and you literally couldn't change your note type. So for one whole day, we were subjected to Koga Ball barking, Mao yelling peace, and Twink shouting directions at us. I used 10 time-limited Dia Scout tickets on the Anipop collab, and I was lucky enough to get all the cards in one pull. Also, you had to score over 50k in the minigame to get the limited title. Finally, I can be happy.
I've been in the kitchen, whipping, whipping. I've been chefing.
OnStar's notifications go crazy. I was just minding my business in Bandori, about to auto-ban for Pastel Palette Stage Challenge, when Ray's feature scout said,
"Come meet me in the dark, young lady."
Listen, there's a lot to unpack there, but I'll just say this. What happened to shame? It took me 4 pulls, 14k Daya, to get Walk With Your Smile, June, and Nagisa. And then it took me 3 pulls, 10.5k Daya, to get Walk With Your Smile, Hiyori, and Ibarra. And of course Ibarra was the last one I got. It was satisfying to get everyone from Cospro though. I scouted for Feature Scout 1 Ibarra a total of 3 times. The first time he released, I spent 30k and didn't get him. And the second time, for the revival, I ended up getting Honeybee Koaku, which was sickening because he was the other revival banner at the time.
It's about damn time. It's about damn time.
So I'm glad Ibarra finally came home the third time. I needed this card too, to make this. me when Kaka tell me to do something. The things I do for memes, truly. I was laughing the first time I saw this. Like, my immersion is ruined every time OnStars unintentionally shows the code. Anyway, journal check. Sorry about the abyss of blank space at the bottom. They did not optimize this for tablet. But shout out to the 5-star cards that actually came home from Impulse Scouting. This Natsume is so cool. Cyber Sniper vibes. This Wataru Unbloomed is so cute, I had to get him. Plus the outfit is fabulous. Yeehaw, Nikki. I actually made sure to get all the cards from that set because it's just that cute. So here's my account as it is right now. My home screen will always be Women's Wear Ibara at Time Street. And if I may speak about the current campaigns, the summer campaign is cool. First of all, the One Piece is real. And I highly doubt it's gonna happen, but if I end up getting like 1 million L or the 5k Dire from the treasure hunt, I will say yippee, like that kid with Fortnite and cola, because I've just been auto-teaming everything. Roll the clip.
It's talking Fortnite and drink cola! Yippee!
This is our Mega Millions. For the Swan campaign, I had to go with Team White because of Cospro. As you can see, I plan on fully uncapping the Natsume, which, to be blunt, has been a real pain in the ass. And I can't wait until I'm done. OnStars really got us out here playing Merge Mansion. I did get enough coins to recreate the Mirage Room in my office though, since they allow us to hide the UI for whatever reason, so that's cool. My office is, has been, and always will be, an Aiden enclosure. It's gonna take forever for me to level up my office to rank 12 because department leveling is expensive as hell. This was my face when I first saw that it costs 2 million.
I am never gonna financially recover from this.
I'm making good progress towards getting all the private outfits. Of course, I especially want to get all the highest level ones for Aiden, but for some reason, out of all the characters, I've already unlocked them all for Izumi, of all people. I've accepted this as his apology for not coming home on basic. Anyway, as you can imagine, everyone is idol rank E aside from Aiden, my C rank legends. Honestly, they could have been rank B by now, it's just that I've been super inefficient at increasing their fans. I simply did not know about advanced auto lineup for increasing fans until literally this week. My society makes me laugh, because it really is my society. Literally just me. It used to be me, my IRL friend, and another person, but they both stopped playing a long time ago, so 99% of the furniture you see here has been farmed for and bought by me. Honestly though, once I heard that I'm missing out on Daya from not being in an actual society with actual members, I felt like Goofus D-Dog. Like, I don't really care about how the society looks, since that's what our offices are for, right? I just want more Daya. What you see here is my attempt at least some enrichment in the enclosure with the little resources I have. So if anyone watching this is in a society that's looking for an active member, me, and y'all are okay with me and Ibara P / Aiden P being in the Pacific time zone for whenever y'all have the joint live, feel free to let me know, invite me, tell me about any rules or whatever, and I will be there no matter what. On the flip side though, if anyone for whatever reason wants to join my severely underdeveloped society, even if the name is Rejects and I don't think I can change it, I'm down for that too. It'll be super duper casual, completing tasks like we're in Among Us. All I ask is that you're down to do joint live together, so we'd have to agree on a time, but I won't be on anyone's ass like, why didn't you do blah 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 for the society? Because I recognize that we all have lives. So TLDR, if you're interested in recruiting me or even joining me, you can DM me in-game or comment here on YouTube, and I will simply do whatever happens first. If nobody want me for real though, I'll just keep working my way towards completing the fresh furniture set by myself for the next however many months or years it takes. It's really no big deal though, it's just that a society of more than just my goofy ass would be nice to have. Anyway, this is my profile. My favorite card will almost always be Bogey Time Ibarra Unbloomed. As for my titles, my Bogey Time ranking will be replaced with whatever I end up ranking for Secret Service Nagisa, since I plan on fully uncapping him. Also, I'm good with just the Ibarra title, but are there really no titles for producing units? Because I'd love an Aiden one. Anyway, I don't know if you can see it, but I use this faint line right here to align everyone's chins. So my profile is looking nice and swaggy thanks to Walk With Your Smile Aiden. But my dream profile is this. Bogey Time Ibarra Unbloomed, which I have. Secret Service Nagisa Unbloomed, which I'm gonna get in the future. Faith Conquest Hiyori, which will be the only thing I'll spend memorial coins on for the next however many literal years it takes to fully uncap from nothing, since that event came out before I really knew how to play the game. And finally, Women Want Fish, Me Fear Me June, which I also already have, so I'm almost there. Before I wrap things up, I just want to give a few shoutouts. Shoutout to Mao's left hand going through his armpit. Shoutout to Fine, because the only times I've gotten 100 Daya from Starry Live is from them. Fine Rich Real. Shout out to K Meta Commu Parameters 157, Text 1 and Text 2. And of course, shout out to Aiden, the found family ever. Cue the montage. Soldier boy, anyway, thank you for watching this big chunkus of a video. Feel free to add me if you actively play. I already have a set of friends who I give work tickets to though, so I can't help you there, but I do try to like all of my friends' offices every week. For future goals, after Secret Service Nagisa, I want to get at least one copy of both Obligato, Himuru, and Tatsumi. I also, shamelessly, want at least one copy of Vampire Kato. The only gacha card I want is Craft Monster Ritsu. Bruh. Honestly, this might be tied for the best card in the game for me. I love the concept, the card art, the 3D outfit, everything is so swaggy. Hopefully I can get at least one of him. So if I have enough Daya by then, my next OnStars video will be scouting for Craft Monster Ritsu. See you next time, and take care.